The Milford Senior Center's proposed fitness room won approval from the Finance Committee after lengthy discussion about whether it should be okayed because it wasn't on a 5-year capital plan. Director Sue Clark spoke passionately about the need for the room to meet a growing demand from residents and really to utilize the available space on the second floor. FinCom member Will Kincaid.
There's no arguing the need for this. There's no arguing that at some point down the road that this was part of the plan to obviously finish a couple more of those rooms. We kind of ended the discussion with, I'm giving an abridged version, but we ended the discussion with my opinion that no one was going to argue the validity of this, but that what was going to be a sticking point probably with the Finance Committee, regardless of how the selectmen felt about it or regardless of whether she went to town meeting and took it directly to the floor, that most of us would probably have an issue with the fact that we've already told other folks that weren't on the 5-year capital plan. So we talked very honestly about that. So, you know, I don't think it's speaking with a forked tongue that this is something that needs to get done, but I know that we've also told a number of people, you didn't get on the plan, you didn't do this, you didn't do that, and we asked them to come back.
Selectman Brian Murray, who chaired the center's building committee a decade ago, said this project has been in the works for years.
You know, if you think about what's happened since the construction of the building, we've already done this. This happened 3 years ago. We did over one of the rooms upstairs. We got an estimate from John Erickson for the construction. We got favorable. It got done. It's a gorgeous shine office upstairs. This has already been done. This is not new stuff. This has been part of what's happened with the senior center.
Cost of the project is $75,000. And the library want approval, too, for money to improve and upgrade electrical services. Director Sue Edmonds explains.
What we're going to do is that nothing really has been upgraded electrically in the library since about 1986. It's all the original outlets. And let's face it, technology has changed in how people use it. And we have a lot more people coming into the library bringing their own devices. And the way the outlets are like all around, like here, all the way around the room, and people bring in their laptops and their mobile devices, and we've got extension cords from them all over the area, and people can trip, and it also doesn't, it clogs up the reference area and the young adult area, so we need to increase the number of electrical outlets in the library so people can plug in and use their devices for researching and also ordering materials from the library.
Money for computer workstations also approved by the FinCom.